Good evening to you and welcome to this World Cup in Rio, Brazil. What a resplendent city, and it's great for the ISSF to be back here for yet another World Cup where we will have quota places at stake over the next week or so. We run through to next Friday. No quota places in this event coming up right now, that's the mixed team, but there are 16 quota places available for 76 countries. 15 of those athletes are from the home nation of Brazil. But for now, this is the 10-meter air pistol mixed team bronze medal match. This is Bulgaria versus Japan in this one. Then we'll move on to the gold medal match in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team. That's Turkey versus Ukraine. But for now, the athletes just lining up out the front. Jamie Stangroom, the announcer from Great Britain, making the introductions as we're about to get underway in this resplendent venue. Now the weather, of course, outside is pretty hot here in Rio, and it's hot and sticky as well inside the actual finals hall as well, so whether or not that'll affect things, we'll have to see. There is Jamie Stangroom, just gave him a mention, looking ever resplendent, bedecked in white today. He's gone for the all white look. Casually just leaning there on the stairs, microphone in hand. He will be the announcer at the Paris Olympic Games. Well, one of the announcers anyhow. Jamie and I were announcers at Tokyo, but my role will be on the television for the Olympics, which starts on the 26th of July. Not long to go now before the Olympic Games gets going. And our focus, of course, not only is on this World Cup, but on the Olympics itself as well. There's Oscar Martinez, Venezuela. Chief Range Officer, a very experienced man in the world of shooting, and he'll be in command. You can just see the stopwatch there. Everything in shooting is done to commands and to the clock. You can also see 5 minutes over to the right That's for the preparation and sighting time before we go into the actual bronze medal match itself. And it's the point system, so it's the first team to get to 16 points. Bulgaria versus Japan in this one for the bronze medal match. That's the start list here at the ISSF Olympic Qualification Championships. So wherever you are around the world, perhaps joining us on YouTube and or Facebook, then thanks very much for coming along. Feel free to leave your comments and subscribe to the channel as well. That way you get notifications, particularly on YouTube. I noticed even earlier on it popped up on my phone to tell me that this bronze medal match was about to get underway. So even drones being used indoors. Hopefully not too much of a distraction for anyone that's actually in the finals hall, because they can make a bit of noise. There's Alfredo Laliafilo just checking the rules as well. It's very commonplace for jury to have the rule book with them, and also in pen they tend to write their surname across the side of the pages so that they know it's theirs. And I've just seen that's something that's become ever more common across the world of the jury members in the world of shooting. So we were here for a World Cup not so long ago. Now it's for this Olympic Qualification Championship for rifle and pistol over the next week right through to next Friday. So there's the Bulgarian team. Miroslava Mincheva and Samuel Donkov. Quite a bit of experience between them. And Vladislav Manev is the coach, just taking some pictures, I'm sure, just to put that in the scrapbook to say, yes, we were here, we made it all the way to Rio. Now we hope to be in Paris in the summer. Here's the Japanese team, and this is Sakata Yamada and Seiji Morikawa. And interesting to note that Sakata has been fourth in three World Cups, so could get a medal here today. There's Emil Dushanov, who's the coach. And meanwhile, Seiji Morikawa competed at the World Championships in Baku last year in 2023. So there's the distance, 10 metres. First team to get to 16 points. It could even go to 17 if there's a tie at 15 points each. And the bullseye, 11.5 millimetres. So just imagine that now. Hold up your arm in front of you, pretend there's a pistol in your hand, and try and see whether or not you think you could hit something that was 11.5 millimetres. I've given this a go myself, and they make it look so easy, believe you me. So just over 2 minutes left to go on the preparation and sighting time before we get underway. My name is Rory McAllister, and I'll be your commentator for both the bronze medal match and the gold medal match, which is coming up in just a second. Well, the cameras certainly liking Jamie today, aren't they? Jamie Stangroom, the announcer for Great Britain, again, so experienced, has worked within shooting since 2016. So now, with 8 years of experience, including many World Championships, many World Cups, and the Tokyo Olympic Games. So some of the achievements of Miroslava Mincheva, just looking at those. I do like these new graphics as well that they've constructed. Sergey, the graphics man, one of the graphics men at CS, I know, has played around and come up with some very clear ways of showing all the data and achievements to us for our viewing pleasure. So just over 1 minute to go. So each team takes their individual shot. The shots are combined, and then the highest total will receive 2 points if at any point there is a tie. And you would think that that was nigh on impossible in the world of shooting, considering it's such a technical sport. Both teams get the same total, then they will be awarded 1 point each, and it's a race to 16 points. I've seen medal matches like this go to 15 points each, in which case then you need to have a clear winner, and often the winning total then has to go to 17. So 20 seconds left, wherever you are around the world. If you're watching on your computer, on your phone or your tablet, then get ready. We've got 10 seconds until we get underway. So you can see the official time clock in the background just coming up to 6 p.m. local time in Rio. And here we have the start of the 10-metre air pistol mixed team bronze medal match at this ISSF Final Olympic Qualification Championship. So who will take the initiative? This is when the hard bit begins. This is when it counts. Breath control, staying as steady as possible. And Miroslava with a bit of a dodgy opening shot, an 8.9 and a 10 from Donkov, so an 18.9. Meanwhile, the Japanese have a total of 20.1, so they take the first points. It's Japan 2, Bulgaria 0. So second series, this is Sakato Yamada. And another shot in the eight ring for Mincheva. So only a total of 18.0 for Bulgaria. Meanwhile, Japan, 20.3. And that's a terrific 10.7 from Yamada. Looks so focused just a few seconds ago. Considering really she's got no major medals of note when you look through her achievements, but does have those fourth places, agonizing fourth place, three times in World Cups. That happened both at Changwon and in Cairo. So Japan 4 points, Bulgaria 0. .3 from Donkov. Again, another steady shot in the 10 ring. And a 9.8 this time from Mincheva. So 20.1. It means Bulgaria are up and running. They have their first points. And that's going to do their confidence at this stage the world of good, because you don't want the other team racing away. Even still, I have seen it in these medal matches where one team is so far in front and you think it's all over, and yet the other team just manages to dig deep and pull it back. That's why shooting is so fascinating. Such a tricky sport, this, it really is. And 19.3 against a 19.7, so Japan just edged it in that series. That 10.4 from Yamada, another great shot from the 29-year-old. And Japan still have the advantage in this bronze medal match. Just see Morikawa just checking his feet placement. It all starts from the feet up. There he goes again, just having a look, running through everything that he's done in training and with his coach. And you will notice Each athlete does have individual styles. Some really lean into their shoulder. Others like that, like Donkov, just much more straightforward in terms of style. He scores an 8.9. Two shots in the nine ring, meanwhile, for Japan. A grimace from Morikawa. And 19.1. It's still enough to take the series. So Japan are halfway there. They're up to 8 points. A 6-point gap between Japan and Bulgaria. So Chief Range Officer gives the load command, and it's so important that the athletes pay attention to the Chief Range Officer's commands. One from Yamada. Is it going to be enough? Well, followed by 10.7. Japan once again have a series win. And looking at the face of Satoko Yamada, you wouldn't think that they were 8 points in front, but just shows you you can't let the occasion get to you. You do have to stay focused, and looks like Bulgaria have called a timeout. And each coach can do that. They're allowed a maximum of 60 seconds. It does mean, though, that the other team can also take advantage of the timeout period. And I think Miroslava Minchova is just saying to the coach, it didn't seem to be happening for me earlier on, but her last shot was a 10.1, so something to be encouraged by. I think again the coach is just reminding them of the mental battle. We did see Minchova earlier on like this, closing her eyes, focusing in on the task in hand. There is a bronze medal at stake here, let's face it. So here we go, Series 7. Another 50 seconds on the clock. Now, so often after the timeouts, you see them have a positive impact. Will that happen here today? From Minchova. So another shot in the 10 ring, followed by an 8.8 from Donkov, a 19.3 total. Meanwhile, Japan have another shot left. It's a 9.6, and it's not enough. Once again, we see the positive impact of the timeout called by Bulgaria, and it's worked in their favour because they've got another two valuable points on the board. It's now Bulgaria 4, Japan 10. And you just see the improvement as well of Miroslava. She did have a bit of a dodgy start. There was that 8.9 shot that she opened up with, then followed by another shot in the 8 ring, and then the improvement is there for you to see. I think the air conditioning in the background there is working overtime. It's quite hot and sticky in the finals hall. This time 18.3 from Bulgaria and a 17.2 total from Japan. Are they starting to wobble? The Bulgarian team have clawed back another 2 points. It's now Bulgaria 6, Japan 10. The gap that was starting to increase is now decreasing. It's only 4 points now between these two teams. And you'd have to say, even at this stage, it's poised. This could be anybody's gold medal. So 20.5 total this time from Japan. Two decent shots in the early tens. 10.3 and a 10.2, and it's enough to take this series. So it's swung back the other way. The gap is back to 6 points. So Japan on 12, and you can just see the mixed form of Satoko Yamada. shot 8 particularly as well was really quite wayward. So series 10, Japan need 4 more points to get to 16 to take the bronze. Meanwhile, Bulgaria need another 10 points. That's 5 series wins. Controlling the breath, controlling the heart rate, controlling your mind, and then controlling your body, and fire, and see what happens. 2 shots in the 9s for Bulgaria, 19.1 against a 19.9 total from Japan. Once again, the Japanese have managed to nick that series. They've been the most consistent team since the beginning of this bronze medal match and are now just 2 points away from the first medal of this ISSF final Olympic qualification championship. Is this the moment Japan will take the first medal of this tournament? Bulgaria go first. They come in with a total of 19.1. And it's a 19.4 from Japan. So the Japanese team have just managed to do it. There was a gap in the end of 10 points. And Seiji Morikawa puts his safety flag back into his pistol. And for the Japanese team, that's a great day's work in the qualification earlier today. And now to come here into the finals hall and take the first medal of this tournament. And massive congratulations from Emil Dushanov, who's the Japanese coach. Meanwhile, for Donkov and Mincheva of Bulgaria, it just wasn't to be today. It's fourth place. Meanwhile, the Japanese team come over, and really nice to see so many smiles, so many hugs. And I think that's sweat that Miroslava's wiping from her face. I don't quite think it's tears just yet. And considering this competition is in Rio, it's nice to see the Rio 2016 boxes come out to pack away the equipment from this bronze medal match. So there we have it, up and running. The first medal has been awarded. It's gone to Japan. It was a shaky start from Bulgaria at the beginning. The timeout had a positive impact, but Japan then just managed to regather, refocus, and sail through to claim the bronze medal. So we'll be back in a few moments' time with the gold medal match here on ISSF TV. Good evening and welcome back to Rio for this ISSF final Olympic qualification championship for rifle and pistol. We're here for the next week and we've already got underway. We've just had a bronze medal match and it was taken by Japan. Quite a sizable gap in the points system as we move now into this gold medal match. This is two giants of the pistol world. There's certain countries that just excel in certain areas. And you'd have to say that Turkey and Ukraine, both countries with the pistol, are always a formidable force. So the athletes just settling in at the moment, getting ready for this. It's quite customary to see all the stickers from previous tournaments stuck onto each pistol. The Turkey team are here with the flag, ready to go. And nice to see them giving us a wave as well. It's always nice as well when the camera points at you just to give it a wave. Nice and relaxed. And who wouldn't be whenever you're in Rio? Surely one of the most relaxed cities around. Here's a fact for you. It has the world's bluest sky, does Rio de Janeiro, which actually means January River. But the actual January River is actually a bay, not a river at all. But that's where Rio de Janeiro actually comes from. So the preparation and sighting time clock is already ticking down. And here is the Turkish team. This is Şevval İlayda Taran. He's 24 years old, nearest us to your screen. And then the ever-present Yusef Dikeç, now 51 years old and still shooting at world level. And that's Rahim Jadavartilu, who's the coach. And I wonder what's going through his mind at the moment as he just looks up to the screens that contain the athletes' names. And here's two formidable members of the Ukraine team. And I say that because Yulia Isachenko is only 15 years old and she's alongside Ole Omelchuk, which, let's face it, Ole has pretty much been in every single competition going. And Vladimir Ivanchuk is the coach. And Ole Omelchuk now at 40 years old alongside this incredible 15-year-old who was seventh at the Junior World Cup 2023 in Seoul. She's also got a sixth place in Tallinn. That was in the air pistol team women junior event. I was there myself to commentate on that one. For now though, this is Turkey versus Ukraine, and it's the Ukraine team too that's made it through to this gold medal match. So one thing's for sure when you get to this sort of stage is you do know you will leave with a medal. Will it be gold or will it be silver? So 11.5 millimetres is the target, 10 metres away. That's the centre of the ring. And the 10.9 is the highest individual score. People have said to me, why is it not 11? I said, I don't know, just watch the shooting. So each athlete will take their individual shots. Then the scores are combined. And the highest score will receive 2 points per team. And if at any point the teams are tied, they'll get 1 point each. So just having a closer look now at Şevval İlayda Taran and that silver medal at Baku last year at the World Championships. Now she also took a gold medal actually at the World Championships as a junior in Changwon. Was there for that one back in 2018. It seems so far away now. I suppose it is 6 years. Here is Yusef Dikeç, now 51 years old and has achieved so much across the globe in the world of shooting. Silver medalist at the World Championship in Baku in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team, this very event. So will it be another silver for today for Yusef, or will it be an upgrade to gold? He's also a two-time gold medalist in the 25-meter at the World Championships. And took a bronze medal at the World Championships in the 10-meter air pistol. And I remember seeing him shoot last year in Tallinn at the European Championships and achieve medals in the team events. So here is Yulia Isachenko, only 15 years old. And there's that seventh place that I was telling you about at the World Cup for juniors in Seoul. It's almost the home of junior shooting, isn't it, Seoul? Such a gorgeous place in the Bavarian area of Germany, steeped in those hills and those surrounding trees. It's a gorgeous place to visit, it really is. And here is Ole Olmochuk, now 40 years old. And look at that, 8 World Cup gold medals, 7 World Cup silvers. And that's not to mention all the bronze medals that you can see there listed, not only from the Olympic Games, but right the way through World Championships, World Cup Finals, right the way across world-class shooting. Ole Olmochuk is certainly already in the history books and is a real legend of this sport. So Chief Range Officer will call for 30 seconds just to let the athletes know. There we go, that's Oscar Martinez of Venezuela, who's the Chief Range Officer for this final. Such an experienced man. And we now have 20 seconds left. So no matter where you are around the world, joining us here on ISSF TV, if you're on YouTube, do subscribe to the channel. That way you'll get notifications of not only our broadcasts of the finals, but also all the other content that we'll bring to you. And I'm sure you've been watching our Road to Paris series, next episode out this Sunday. So this is the 10-metre air pistol mixed team gold medal match. Wherever you are around the world watching, perhaps on your computer, your phone, your tablet, thanks very much for coming along and joining in with us and celebrating the world of shooting sport. Here we go. So first series, clock is ticking down. Such stillness there across all four of our athletes. The breath control is just incredible. It's something so simple. We all do it in our lives. We just walk around breathing. We never think about it. But when it comes to shooting, it's such a massive part of what you're doing. So a 10.7 shot from Olmochuk, the highest individual shots right the way across the board. And it means added to Isachenko's 9.7. It means Ukraine have the first advantage in this gold medal match. Ukraine already now on 2 points with that highest combined total. Turkey for the moment remain on 0. Here's series 2. So it was Olmochuk that fired first. This time, 2 shots in the 9 ring for Ukraine. A total of 19.1 is not enough. And Turkey have levelled it up again already. So will this be one of those gold medal matches where there's hardly anything to separate both teams? But unfortunately, of course, there has to be something to separate them by the end, because somebody has to take the gold medal. Somebody has to go home with silver. Another 50 seconds, which again, as you're watching from home, may feel like a long time, but when you're hovering around with a pistol and you think about your whole movement from the very beginning, actually lift the pistol, raise it, aim it, take some concentration, and time can get the better of you if you let it, and that's where experience counts. 20.6 from Turkey. That's an impressive total. 2 shots in the 10 ring, a 10.4 and a 10.2. Meanwhile, another 2 shots in the 9 ring from Ukraine. That's the second series in a row where that's happened. And Turkey now on to 4 points, Ukraine on 2. So 21.8 is the highest possible combined score. That's if both athletes were to hit a 10.9. I have seen it happen. It's rare, but it's just brilliant when it does happen. 9.8 against two shots in the tens, a 20.4 total for Ukraine. It's a 19.2 total for Turkey, or Turkey, as they've been more recently called. And it's now level. So an exciting start to this gold medal match. The bronze medal match a few moments ago was just completely different to this one. This is level all the way so far, and it's the first team to 16 points who will take gold. Now you'll see Ormolchuk there, the last one to lower his pistol down. Each athlete has their own individual style, it's just whatever works. A slight improvement for Isachenko with a 10.2. Ormolchuk this time hits a 9.4. And Turkey have just managed to snatch that series win. And these are the fine margins in shooting. This is what it comes down to. And this is where you have to just keep going. And even if you have a bad shot in one series, you can regather, regroup, time to shoot again, and try and improve on what you've just done. It's a constant battle against yourself and a constant battle with the target. Can Ukraine pull this back and level up this gold medal match? Ooh, shots in the nine ring for now. A 10.4 from Taran. And that saved it for Turkey. Those two 9.2s from Ukraine are just now the difference. And I've just seen Ormolchuk take quite a long look down to the Turkish team. And I wonder what's going through his mind at the moment. Is perhaps that the series that makes the turn in this gold medal match? Because Turkey 8 now halfway there. 16 points is the golden total for the gold medal match. And they're now on 8 points. Ukraine on 4. .1 from Diketch. 10.4 meanwhile from Isachenko. And another 9-shot ring. 9.4 from Ormolchuk. And what's happening to the 40-year-old shooter? Just down at the end there. And perhaps just looking a little bit dazed as the coach comes over to call for a timeout. And Vladimir Ivanchuk will take all of the 60 seconds, I would think, that's allowed for these timeouts. And they're now just going over to have a word with Ormolchuk. Well, I can't lip read, but I'm sure the words are something along the lines of, you're good, you know you can do this, you've done it before, just reset yourself and see if you can pull back some more points in this next series. Meanwhile, two great shots in the 10 ring from the Turkish athletes, from Taran and Diketz. A 10.7 was just 0.2 off the perfect score of a 10.9. Now, will this timeout have a positive impact? It so often does. So the load command is given. There's the start command. And the athletes now know that they're free to take their shots within the allocated time of 50 seconds. Turkey, 6 points away from a gold medal. And an 18.9 total from Ukraine. Is that going to be enough? Well, here we have it, our first draw. Would you believe it? When you look at the chances of how a draw can take place in the world of shooting with so many decimals involved, such a finite technical sport, and yet just goes to show you that even at this level, teams can be tied. So that means it's 1 point each. So Turkey notch up to 11 points. Ukraine are now on 5 points. Such stillness from Taran. She almost looks like a statue. Just a little bit of movement in the palm. And you can see her just trying to correct that. Diketz, meanwhile, has hit a 10.6 and a 9.7 from Taran with a 20.3 total. It means that Ukraine have managed to get another series win. And even Taran, just a smile. She knows. And I think we saw it too. I think she was close to the centre, wanted to fire, and there was just that little bit of movement in her hand. She tried to reset, tried to regather, and then you're under pressure with the clock, and you've got to take your shot. So a valuable series win for Ukraine. You see Ormachuk opting for the blinder, covering his non-shooting eye, whereas Diketz just shoots with no blinder. I'm not sure I could shoot without a blinder, to be honest. But then again, the last time I tried pistol shooting, it wasn't worth even telling you about, to be honest. So a 19.8 total from Turkey, this time a 20.2 total. Such a recovery from Omelchuk. You can just see how he started so well, dipped in the middle, and those last four or five shots, there's been a vast improvement. He's now up into the mid-tens with that last shot. Meanwhile, Turkey 8 now call a timeout. So Rahim Jalavari, I'm sure, will take the allocated 60 seconds. And Taran perhaps even having one more joke about that shot a few seconds ago. And this, of course, sometimes is the beauty of a timeout. Sometimes a coach can call it just to disrupt the other team, to disrupt the flow. It might not even necessarily have anything to say. Might just have called the timeout because Ukraine had two series wins. So if you are just joining us, then welcome along. This gold medal match is getting near to the end, and there's only 2 points in it between Turkey and Ukraine. Such a close gold medal match. Oh, 10.5 from Omelchuk. What a shot at this stage. Meanwhile, two shots in the 10 ring from Turkey. 10.4 and a 10.2. It's a total of 20.6, and it's enough to take the series win. Turkey now find themselves 3 points away from taking the gold medal. And that 10.5 from Omelchuk, that was another shot in the mid-10s. But 15-year-old Ulia Isachenko could only manage a shot in the nines. And you can see there, Diketz been pretty consistent over this gold medal match. Those five shots have been above 10. And just notice the way he takes those early blinks, and then the eyes just stay open, takes his shot, looks down. He's so experienced, just makes it look so simple. 20.3 total for Turkey, 10.1 and a 10.2. Turkey now 1 point away. So Ukraine now need to win every single remaining series if they're to take the gold medal, because a draw at this stage would give Turkey a point, which means they would get to 16 and take gold. Ukraine would notch up to 10 points and have to settle for silver. Is this the last series? Series 13, unlucky for some, if you believe in superstitious stuff. Chuck, the last to lower his pistol takes so much time. But he's so experienced. And Turkey both fired. 19.9. Two tens from Ukraine. They've managed to do it by 0.1. Just look at the margin. And that just shows you at this kind of level, you never know when it's over. And would you believe it, Ukraine, such spirit, such fight, have said, no, we're not going to settle for silver. We would like a gold medal. And a very impressive shot from Isachenko, the 15-year-old as well, to match Olya Omelchuk. And what an occasion for her, standing next to this legend of the shooting world. And to think she's 25 years younger than Olya Omelchuk. It's incredible. So Turan looks disappointed. Diketz only manages a 9.6. That's an 18.7. Ukraine have done it again. And a 19.0 total. It was only two 9.5s, but it was enough. And they've won that series by a difference of 0.3. And just as I said a few moments ago, you never know when it's over in shooting. And this is why it's so dramatic. This is exactly why we come here, to see occasions like this. Turkey only need a draw. Of course, a series win would put them to 17 points. And they'll take gold. Can Ukraine level this gold medal match? Can they take a series win? Taran lowers into her shot on the left of your picture. Meanwhile, Isachenko trying to remain as still as possible, controlling her breath. And a 9.5 from Isachenko. Meanwhile, it's a cracking shot from Taran. A 10.8 and a total of 20.6 means Turkey have done it. They're over the line. And what a gold medal match that was. They really had to put up a fight. And Youssef Diketz, it's hugs all round. Both sides. Why not? And he takes off his visor, ruffles his hair. And just looks so cool, calm and collected. It's amazing, really. He's just taken another gold medal to add to his Italian collection. Which just makes it look so simple. Meanwhile, Ukraine. What a great performance from Isachenko. Only 15 years old alongside Olya Omelchuk, who's now 40. And they're just taking the flags away just because it's the official announcement and presentation, because the bronze medalists will also come out to have their medal announced by Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain. So this is where the jury come in, to work so hard in order to get everyone in the right order. So here are the bronze medalists. So Sakato Yamada and Seiji Morikawa of Japan officially announced as the bronze medalists with pistols aloft. So Yulia Isachenko and Olya Omelchuk are the silver medalists. So Sheval Ilaida Taran and Youssef Diketz, delighted for Turkey as they take the first gold medal of this ISSF Final Olympic Qualification Championship for Rifle and Pistol. Well, that concludes both medal matches in the bronze and gold. Hope you enjoyed them. Thank you very much for coming along. We'll see you in a few days' time. We've got no finals tomorrow, but on Sunday, 9:30 local time in Rio de Janeiro, the 10-metre air pistol for women and 11 a.m. for the 10-metre air pistol men. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you in a few days' time.
The first time I've been in the state, congratulations, the medal is here in Rio. work of the Lord, and something that I really appreciate for my family.
Enjoy the moment, but of course the hard work now begins. Good luck with your quest for a place for the Paralympics. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much. Great. Thank you very much, Dylan. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations.
And you think you have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to
go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the store and have to go to the Thank you.
We're going to
is once again to our medal winning teams in the Tony Gardner Store, and here's the conclusion of the event. Japan, Ukraine, and Turkey. That's it all for day one final. Just the eyes of the final of the Olympic qualification championship for Rifle Pistol Rio 2024. Thank you for joining us. We wish you a safe journey home. I'm going to see you tomorrow.